Growth slowing down to around 5%. The next slide on the right, gross capital formation actually being negative now from a high of 20%. So you see the slide, there's no investments practically into in the economy. Fiscal deficit thanks to some financial jugglery showing something like 5%, 4%. But from a peak of 6.5% coming down a little. Inflation struggling, but again signs of slowing down. So you find that GDP growth basically has slowed, and high deficits and inflation leading to pressure on interest rates. Simultaneously, you have seen the slide in the rupee from an average of 45 about 3 years back down to 60 now. These are monthly averages, so you won't capture the lowest, which went down to 69. And this further aggravates the situation in the economy through import and import-led inflations. With this economic background, which all of us are familiar with, let me now go to the banking sector. The bank credit growth rates are slowing down again the last few years from 25% to 14%. And more importantly, if you see the composition of the credit growth, it's primarily been working capital rather than investments. Companies basically having mismatches in working capital, delays in project completion leading to escalation in project costs, leading to shortage in equity from sponsors, leading to them borrowing for equity, which are relatively short term, and all sorts of mismatches that you see. And all this has led to the increase in NPAs, the numbers that we have from RBI and bank reports saying going up to 4%. But if you include restructured assets, it's as much as 9% of total loans. The moderator mentioned, basically the percentage share of infrastructure in bank credit again rising from a low of 2% few years back, a decade or so back, and to as high as 15% now as a share of total credit. On the other side, you can look at the NPAs in infrastructure. The total NPAs plus restructured assets for the banking sector as a whole has been 9%. This is a little dated last year data. But you see infrastructure has been 17%. So bank credit to infrastructure has not necessarily been great.